The six-week-long battle for the ISIS-held city of Mosul has become an increasingly tough urban war for the American-backed Iraqi forces. Up to 1 million civilians still live in the city. The front lines are often too dangerous for international aid workers, but two young American volunteers are there, saving lives while risking their own. From Mosul, special correspondent Jane Ferguson and producer Matt Begary filed this report. A warning, viewers may find some of the imagery disturbing.
Crying in pain, a tiny patient is carried into this basic treatment center in Mosul. His name is Karam, and at just 5 years old, the agony and fear are too much.
Hawa,
says his father. Mortar. His leg was shattered when it was hit 2 weeks ago. It was operated on and is now infected. His father tries to comfort him. For parents, war brings a terrible fear of loss.
Hold that arm in just 1 second.
Hold this arm?
Yeah.
Two American medics are helping Karam. They have been at this post for about a month, treating civilians injured in the fighting.
How many of your patients are children?
Too many.
At least a quarter, minimum.
Injured by?
Everything.
Car bombs, mortars, snipers.
Karam is lucky. He managed to find treatment from ISIS doctors. It's crude, but at least he'll be able to walk again. He probably won't lose the leg.
Is this kind of injury common?
The injury, yeah. Them actually making it into surgery is less common.
So where would he have gone for the surgery?
He went to in Mosul. Still operating hospitals there.
Inside ISIS territory?
Yeah. Yeah, but they're coming, right? Two of them are coming, right?
These
now.
Two American volunteers, both just 27 years old, are the first and only point of help civilians and Iraqi army soldiers get this close to the front line of fighting in Mosul.
Go back with them, and they can help repair them.
Pete Reed is from Bordentown, New Jersey. After two tours in Afghanistan as a Marine, Pete came to Iraq to help. Derek Coleman is from San Diego. He was a machinist in a factory with some medical training before coming here as a volunteer.
I don't have any kids, girlfriend, wife, nothing like that, so I wanted a little adventure and see ISIS as an evil enemy and saw good people fighting against it, and I thought I could help somehow. And medical work seems to be much more important than carrying a gun and shooting at people.
Other charities are miles back from the front lines, wary of putting their staff in harm's way. Because of ISIS suicide car bombs, the civilians of Mosul are banned from driving cars. Many of the injured would not survive if Pete and Derek were not this close to the fighting.
The location is everything with what we're doing. NGOs and other organizations can't get anywhere close to where we are. So what we're doing is we're stopping bleeding that would kill someone in 5 minutes. We're stabilizing patients so they can hopefully survive the trip to the closest hospital. Even with us, the hospitals are so far away at this point that we're afraid of how many patients we lose on the road.
But being this close to the front puts Derek and Pete at risk. They are always short on supplies, so Pete has gone out to search for any other medical stations to ask for more.
Can't check in with them.
Derek just begins telling us about missing the holiday.
Thanksgiving was interesting because Thanksgiving is also when I left home last year, so I had a turkey sandwich alone. That was a little close.
Yeah, let's get down.
Bullets start flying, and we have to run for cover.
This is normal, this kind of gunfire going overhead.
Yeah, it's pretty normal. Our proximity to the front line, it's bound to happen.
Derek calls to warn Pete to be careful. The fighting has intensified around us.
Hey buddy, how you doing? We've had quite a few rounds pass really close to our CCP here, worse than yesterday. So I just want to give you guys a warning as you're pulling up and just check in with you.
In the meantime, Derek prepares for the next patients, which will surely come. The conditions here are harsh, but they have learned to manage.
But as you can see, I'm kind of bloodied here, and I don't really have time to always clean it all off, so I just try to not look like I came out of a butcher shop as best I can.
Pete arrives back empty-handed. his search for supplies unsuccessful. Just as more patients are brought in. The center is also the first point of treatment for many Iraqi soldiers, their bodies brutalized by the urban warfare that rages just down the road. We are not allowed to film the injured and dying soldiers who arrived at the center. Iraqi Special Forces medics are here too, some trained by the two young Americans. They often treat civilians, many transported here by the army in war-weathered Humvees. Soon, one pulls up, and a child wrapped in a blanket is lifted from it. A soldier races her into the center. Her aunt stays outside, hysterical with fear and grief.
Hold her head, somebody.
The small girl has been shot in the head by an ISIS sniper. Incredibly, she is still alive. Pete and Derek fight hard to save her life.
Tell her to stay still, stay still.
They manage to bandage her head.
Plaster?
Plaster, plaster, take a plaster.
Right here, Derek, I need
you. Yeah, I got it. She's still bleeding.
Despite brave efforts, the little girl died.
Do you think, given what you've witnessed, that ISIS are deliberately targeting civilians?
Yeah. They're shooting people with white flags. They're shooting kids. Last week, we had two kids in a row had been shot in the neck of the head by a Daesh sniper because they were fleeing Mosul. Not accidental grazing fire or anything like that. Proper sniper shots, head and neck and face. Yeah, they're purposely trying to kill these people who are running away.
Being in the crossfire and tending to death, his family are worried about him.
Yeah, they worry a lot, probably for good reason. Who wouldn't worry? It's not like I'm a ski instructor in Wyoming. I'm on the front lines in the battle for Mosul. They're really, really supportive. They're just terrified of what I'm doing.
Are you changed?
Am I changed? Yeah. You can only see so many dead kids a day, so many days in a row before you're going to be changed. People see one dead kid or one traumatic thing happen and it affects them for the rest of their life. I've seen a couple hundred. I'm doing okay.
Inside, spirits are high because Karam, the first child we met, is feeling better. A little tenderness and some candy have helped. He has been fortunate to cheat death in this violent place. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jane Ferguson in Mosul, Iraq.